Welcome back to Circuit Showdown. We're back with all three contestants who are facing a new intense challenge.
That's right. Not only do they need to create a project that demonstrates systems commonly found in manufacturing, but now they need to create an IoT dashboard using the Arduino IoT cloud to show that data visually.
So, okay, Raymond introduced a nice little twist to the contestants. What do you all think about that?
I think it keeps it interesting for the contestants. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So what are they going to have to deal with? Let me ask that a different way. What are they going to have to deal with now that they have to move everything into the cloud and create a dashboard?
I think each one has a slightly different set of challenges. I think to some extent they're already doing a little bit in the cloud to tie that in, but I like the twist because it works the same way we do in business today.
Right.
Everything has to be communicated. How do you get your information out in a format that people can understand and access?
So Massimo, is it going to create a technical challenge for them moving it from the IDE to the cloud?
Not a massive challenge.
Okay.
Clearly they are not expert in it, so there's a bit of a curve, but you know.
It's doable.
It's a challenge, but we were not unfair.
All right, contestants, 30 minutes left. All right, guys, you have 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up, stop building.
Here's a design tip from Renesauce. Take advantage of the unique strengths of Wi-Fi, Bluetooth Low Energy, and NFC by adding multiple connectivity options to smart home designs. For example, you can add NFC to a Bluetooth device to get fast and secure touch-to-pair functionality. Modern smart home devices may use Bluetooth Low Energy in a low-power standby state, and then use Wi-Fi to transfer data to and from the cloud. With so many multi-mode chipsets available, it's easier than ever before to improve the end-user experience with support for multiple wireless connection types. In addition, the Matter protocol provides connectivity between devices from different manufacturers, making it an important addition to modern smart home devices.
All right, Michael, what's the story? How did it go?
Okay, well, I'll start with that. It didn't go as exactly as I was planning. Moving it to cloud did not work at all in any of my favor. It set me back quite a bit. And so the actual design that I was hoping to go with was supposed to be what I was gonna call the automated long duration welder, or ALD welder for short. It was supposed to go ahead and take place of a professional welder in settings like construction, oil and gas. What I do have is it working basically my servos. But essentially, it would basically run along a track that would run around the weld. This would end up running along the track, and this would also hold the actual TIG welder, which will provide the welds as it goes. And it would basically cycle back and forth doing the multiple passes as it goes. What I was struggling with is actually getting the sensors that I needed that I would imagine would be important to be able to communicate the temperature, the humidity, and then an actual thermal imaging camera, so that way while you're away you can still supervise the welds and make sure you don't have any bleed through, along with a voltage regulator.
About how much more time do you think you would need to get into the cloud to get it operating?
I'm hoping it was supposed to be these last 10 minutes.
All right, well, we're a little disappointed that it didn't get there, as obviously you are.
Right. Yeah.
We understand that, but I like the concept and appreciate the effort you've put into it.
Yeah, I appreciate the time, thank you.
Thanks. Winning this contest would be an awesome just part of my career. I think it'd be a fun experience. I love doing design work and just trying to come up with new ideas. Contests like this are always super fun because they put you in a position that really lets you learn and under stress, and sometimes that's where the best ideas come from.
All right, hello.
Hi, judges.
Hi, can you restate for us your project?
So basically my goal was to make a remote beehive monitoring system for beekeepers who have lots of hives in agricultural areas. So what I came up with was what I'm calling BeeBot. It is a system of this Arduino Nikola vision board, and then on the inside I have a Portenta with a temperature sensor, humidity sensor, loudness sensor, and a GPS. And the Nikola vision is able to recognize the bees. So this little Arduino sticker is going to be a little stand-in for a bee. So if I hold it up, you can see it recognizes it, and then the bee can go in. I don't have any like counting set up, but this could be used to track the numbers of bees going in and out of the hive. And then for the temperature and humidity, I'm gonna get it out of this box real quick. So for the temperature and humidity, I have a live dashboard. So you can see now that I'm talking next to it, the loudness, things are increasing. Mm-hmm. And if I breathe on the sensor, it should increase. There's a bit of a delay. My goal was to make something that would decrease the labor required for beekeepers to manage their hives, mm-hmm. and keep them from having to go outside in like really hot conditions. And I think I'm happy with where I got.
I have a stupid question. Why the GPS?
GPS was, my thought was if you have multiple of these, it would make it easier to identify which bees are in which location. And also, this is kind of not a super common issue, but bee theft does happen. And bees are quite valuable. So people will just like pull up in a truck and put beehives in the back of their truck, and your whole colony is gone. So. Yeah.
Sorry.
Who knew?
Okay. Yeah. Okay, good job, bro.
Thank you.
That's good. We all learned something there. Yeah. I don't think any of us would have realized that. Yeah.
Winning this competition would mean a lot to me. I just really want to make the people who have helped me get to this point in my life so far proud. And professionally, I just really want to represent Rice well and kind of show everyone who I've learned from what I can do.
Charles.
Howdy.
Hello.
Can you remind us of your project?
So my project was the goal of keeping workers cool on the job, especially workers who have distance to travel, like warehouses, or people who work in construction, to work outside, especially even the heat. So my objective here was to have sensors to detect the worker's body temperature and whether they're beginning to sweat, and then activate fans automatically depending on that. So if I had time, I was going to also try to implement that data remotely. I think all I have right now is the data collected in the Arduino cloud, not quite on the dashboard. But the example here, so I have a heat sensor. I'm gonna just rely on it to kind of heat it up. But at some point when it gets hot enough, it's a little bit above body temperature, the motors activate. It does update live what the temperature is. I think threshold like 24°C at the moment. So in this case, because as soon as I stop breathing, it gets back to below that threshold, it stops off very quickly. The other trigger, though, is when a worker begins to sweat, so just a little bit of water or moisture on the moisture sensor, something like this, and it will activate, stay activated as long as there's still sweat detected on that sensor. Other when I had this going for a while, I actually used it to cool down that sensor to bring it back down to threshold, and the same thing, once sweat begins to dry up and you know, remove, it cuts back out.
And what inspired this idea? How'd you come up with
What I'm wearing right now is what I like to call engineering casual. So long pants, closed-toed shoes. If you go anywhere outside for any amount of time during the summer, especially here, you get toasty pretty quickly. So it'd be nice to have something that you could, with you know, white case or whatever, kind of clip on either a shirt, or my idea was clip on the bottom of your pant legs or whatever, right? Activate fans every now and then just to get a little bit of a breeze. It's not gonna save you, but it might feel a little bit of relief for a moment.
Thank you.
All right, yes, thank you very much.
Good job.
Well, if I win, one thing that I've been wanting to do for a while is once I move into a place that's just myself, I have some space for myself, I've been wanting to set up my own kind of workstation so I can do my own projects. Right now I've been using the college's kind of facilities with oscilloscopes, multimeter, and stuff like that. So I want to build up what I have currently. I just have a multimeter, get the big four, as I call them, with all the benchtop stuff, so I can do my projects from home comfortably, kind of just grow from there.
Struggling with AC noise, temperature rise, and an efficient power conversion in your designs? Vishay, IHLP inductors are highly effective at blocking AC noise and reducing losses by up to 60% compared to traditional composite core materials. These inductors excel in high ripple conditions, offering superior performance and thermal management capable of withstanding temperatures of up to 155 degrees Celsius. Transform your designs with Vishay, where innovation meets reliability.
All right, contestants, everybody, you did a wonderful job. At this time, we are going to ask you to leave the Mouser Innovation Lab so the judges can discuss.
And we're gonna figure out who is the winner of the first Circuit Showdown.
All right.
I know this is going to be a tough decision.
It's going to be a tough one.
Yes.
Love to hear some feedback before we let you go.
I think both Charles and Renee, they were much farther along. And it looks like Michael may have hit a wall. Conceptually, I thought the design was well-intentioned, but I just don't think he fully executed.
To me, the concepts were all very interesting. You know, we all have an idea of what is industrial or you know type of automation, and we've had side discussions. It's such a broad field that I was impressed with the variations that we got, and I liked that each one was able to come in with a perspective of here's how I got to that. It has something to do with a personal experience or something they're familiar with, which. You know, they say, you know, stick with what you know, it makes it easier, and I think they all did that.
They all had interesting perspective, and I kind of like the project that we're working on. It's funny because I saw one of them was kind of, I don't know, a bit cheeky, because he said, oh, I'm sending the data to the cloud, but he was just watching the serial output of the board.
At this point, we're going to give you some time to discuss amongst yourselves, and we'll come back and check on you, and by that time, have a decision.
We'll have a decision.
Okay.
We hope so.
All right.
Propel your technology forward faster than the competition with Mouser Electronics. We have the greatest number of newest product introductions on hand, so you can design in more capabilities without slowing down. Our inventory empowers and accelerates your solutions, giving you what you need most, time. What are you waiting for?
Have the judges reached a decision?
We have made a decision.
Okay, let's get our contestants.
Well, contestants, let me start by saying everyone, one, you all made it here. You competed against several other students to get here. You endured intense pressure and you designed some amazing work. So congratulations to you all. But unfortunately, as you can imagine, our job was very difficult, and we had to rely heavily on the criteria. Michael, I thought your automated welding system was very unique, and you didn't say this, but I sensed that there was some kind of personal connection to welding, because that's not a topic that would have come to my mind, at least. Renee, the Beehive monitoring system was highly original. I never would have imagined that type of concept, and I think you did a really nice job with all of your sensing capabilities. And then Charles, your wearable personal monitor, I thought was very original. Again, they were all unique ideas.
I want to talk a little bit about the theme of today. When it came into industrial automation, I had something in my mind that I think of when I think of industrial. I think all of the judges did. And you guys, I think, really nailed it. If you remember back when Raymond presented it, he said something to deal with safety, productivity, and quality. Charles, yours was primarily safety, but it also affects a little bit of productivity. You know, if someone's, you know, happier or, you know, working a little harder, you know those kinds of things, we think the safety's good. Renee, the productivity piece of it is kind of what I took out of it. But again, it's a safety factor, those kinds of things. And then Michael brought in some more of the quality, how to improve quality of a system, and also the productivity. So you guys all did a very good job of carrying the theme, of at least two areas of what we talked about in the theme, and you could argue that every one of them hit all three of those in some way, shape, or form.
Yeah, so one of the other categories was criteria was the usage of resources. So I think, you actually throughout the two days, you actually used a range of sensors. So it was good to see that you use different technologies. So we appreciate that. There was also an extra category that we added, which is the cloud, because you were asked last minute to do that. And so it's interesting how, some were more successful than others. And so in a way, we understand we kind of throw you a kind of curveball kind of in the middle of the episode, but that's what happens in life. And so we had to kind of evaluate you on that too.
Like the judges said, this was very close. But at this time, unfortunately, we are going to have to say goodbye to Charles.
It was a pleasure watching both of you work, and I am very proud of all of you that competed. And our winner today is Renee. Congratulations. Do you want to let the holder for
you? Thank you. Got it now.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
It really was fun watching you guys work.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm feeling good, like rested now that it's over. Had a good time while there, but definitely enjoy the kind of the peace afterward.
Oh, most definitely. I love this experience. If anyone else had the opportunity, I would recommend it as well. I most definitely would love to come back if we can.
Yeah, it was just an amazing experience. I learned so much. And I feel like just getting to be around everyone and getting to be in the environment here was really just like, it kind of showed me what I can look forward to for like working after I get out of college. So it's kind of like helping me see the light at the end of the tunnel. Just like seeing people who've been working in this industry for so long. The experience overall was just super, super positive, and I had a great time.
And that is the conclusion of Circuit Showdown.
We'd like to take a minute to thank our sponsors, Arduino, Keysight, Molex, Renesas, and Vishay, for helping to make this all possible. I'm Nicolette Amino.
And I'm Brian DeLuca, and we're from eDesign, and we'll see you next time on Circuit Showdown, powered by Mouser Electronics.